Welcome to the spoken tutorial on Introduction to GChemPre. In this tutorial, we will learn about GChemPre interface and menus, configure the settings, and customize the activities. To record this tutorial, I am using Ubuntu Linux OS version 16.04, GChemPre version 0.96 and a working internet connection. To follow this tutorial, learner should be familiar with basic computer skills. Please use the given link to download the GChemPre application. To open GChemPre, go to the Downloads folder. Double-click on GChemPre Installer folder for Linux. Then, double-click on Bin folder to open it. In this folder, right-click and select Open in Terminal option. At the prompt, type sh space gchempre-qt.sh and press Enter.
Welcome to GChemPre.
GChemPre application opens. About GChemPre. The interface is designed for easy use by small children. Computer with a mouse is essential for learning GChemPre. You can also use other pointing devices such as joystick, touchpad, stylus pen, etc. For more information, use the given link. GChemPre graphic interface is shown here with a list of activities at the top and a control bar at the bottom. All the activities are grouped under 8 sections. Each section is represented with an icon. Click on the icon that shows a cat with a keyboard and a mouse. List of the activities in this section are displayed on the interface. All the activities shown in this section will train the child in using mouse and keyboard. Click on Make the ball go to Tux activity. The activity opens with a hint message. This hint message gives an idea about how to play the activity. After reading the message, click on the Start button. At the bottom of the screen, we see a control bar. It has Help icon, Home icon, and back and forth arrow icons. We can hide or show the control bar with the help of Hide Show icon. Let's click on Help icon. A page opens. Here we see the instruction to play the activity, author, manual, and section of the activity. To close the page, click on the red cross icon at the top right corner. Back and forth arrow icons are used to select the level of the activity. Here, the number indicates the level of the activity. Higher levels correspond to greater difficulty level. In GChemPre, it is possible to go to the next level without completing the current level. Home icon is used to quit the activity. Click on the Home icon. It leaves the current activity and takes you to the previous menu. Click on Cow with ABC icon. List of activities under this category appear on the interface. In this category, we have activities related to reading letters, words, typing text, etc. Select, click on a lowercase letter activity. The activity opens on the interface.
Click on the required letter. You can listen to it again by clicking on the mouse. Click on a letter. A.
We heard a voice giving instructions about how to play the activity. It asks us to click on the spoken letter. Lisp symbol is present at the top right corner of the interface. Click on this symbol to listen to the letter again.
A.
We can disable the sound if we don't want to hear the audio. This can be done using the configuration page. Click on the home icon to quit the activity. At the bottom of the interface, we can see a control bar. It has quit icon, about gcompare icon, help icon and toolbox icon. The toolbox icon is represented with a spanner image. Click on the toolbox icon. A configuration page opens with list of settings that can be enabled or disabled. Click on the arrow icon available at the bottom right corner to see the complete list. Here, we can see two options to set the audio: enable audio voices and enable audio effects. The green tick mark indicates that the setting is enabled. The red cross mark indicates that the setting is disabled. Uncheck the enable audio voices and enable audio effects options. Click on the red cross icon at the top right corner to close the page. Go to the click on a lowercase letter activity again. Note that audio is now disabled. Hence, lips symbol also disappears. Click on the home icon to quit the activity. Let's see the other settings available on the configuration page. Go to the configuration page again. Full screen option is listed here. We can resize the gcompare interface with the help of this option. Let's keep this option as it is. In the gcompare, a lot of activities require virtual keyboard. Whenever you need this keyboard, enable the virtual keyboard option. Let us keep the options shown here as it is. Close the configuration page. Next, we will see the settings to change the font style, size, spacing, etc. with an activity. Scroll down and click on Image Name Activity. Let's change the font size, style, spacing and case of the words. For this, go to the configuration page again. Click on the Font Selector button. A list of font styles is displayed. I will select Bistrim Charter. Then, drag the font size slider to increase the font size. Next is a font capitalization setting. Click on Font Capitalization button. Here we can change all the letters to mixed case or uppercase or lowercase. I will select All Uppercase option. Next, drag the font letter spacing slider to change the spacing between the letters. Now, close the configuration page and open the image name activity. Observe that properties of the font had changed. Click on the home icon to quit the activity. In gcompare, we can also change the language for the activity. For this, go to the configuration page again. To listen to the audio again, we will enable the two audio settings. Scroll down and click on Language Selector button. Here is the list of all languages. Select the language as per your requirement. I will select Hindi. Below the Language Selector button, we have an option to update localized voices. Click on the Download button. A pop-up window opens. It shows that your download is completed. The data files are now accessible. Close the pop-up window. To see the changes on the interface, restart the gcompare application. To restart the gcompare application, close the gcompare window. On the terminal, type the command as shown earlier
and press Enter to open.
सर्वांगीण विकास संस्था जी कॉम्प्रेस खेलों में आपका हार्दिक स्वागत करती है.
नोटिस दैट द लैंग्वेज इज नाउ चेंज टू हिंदी. क्लिक ऑन काउ विथ एबीसी आइकॉन. ऑब्जर्व दैट टाइटल्स ऑफ द एक्टिविटीज हैव चेंज टू हिंदी. सेलेक्ट क्लिक ऑन एन अपरकेस लेटर एक्टिविटी.
सही अक्षर पर क्लिक करें.
Now we can listen to the instructions in Hindi. Let us go back and configure the settings to the default language, which is English. Go to the configuration page. Notice that instructions are now in Hindi. Scroll down and click on Language Selector button. Change the language to your default system language. Restart the GCompli application to see the activities in English. Let's see how to filter the activities according to the difficulty level. Open the configuration page. Scroll down the list to see the difficulty filter option. Difficulty filter option allows you to filter the activities as per the age group. The stars indicate the age group for which each activity is designed. First three yellow stars are for 4 to 6 years old children. Next three red complex stars are for the children above 6 years of age. Select the stars according to your difficulty level. To deselect the activities, click on the stars. I want to deselect the activities for 4 to 6 years old. So, I am clicking on the yellow stars. Close the configuration page. Observe that all the sections now have activities intended for kids above 6 years. Go to the configuration page again. Click on the deselected yellow stars to show all the activities. Close the configuration page. Click on the sun icon at the top left corner of the interface. This will take you to the home page. On the interface, we can see a message. This message asks us to select favorite activities from different categories. To do so, first click on any activity of your choice. I will click on Tux icon. You will see an icon of sun at the top right corner of each activity. Click on it to select the activity. Select your favorite activities under different categories. After selecting the activities, click on the sun icon at the top left corner. Now, we can see all the selected activities on the main interface. Click on the sun icon at the top right corner of each activity. Then click on the sun icon at the top left corner on the main activity bar. This will remove the activities under the selected category. The quit icon at the bottom of the interface is used to quit the GCompli application. We can also use Ctrl and Q keys together on the keyboard to quit the GCompli application. Let us summarize. In this tutorial, we have learnt about GCompli interface and menus, configure the settings, and customize the activities. As an assignment, open the configuration menu. Using the difficulty filter option, select games for 4 to 6 years old children and change the language for the activities as per your choice. The video at the following link summarizes the spoken tutorial project. Please download and watch it. The spoken tutorial project team conducts workshops using spoken tutorials and give certificates on passing online test. For more details, please write to us. Do you have questions in this spoken tutorial? Please visit this site. Choose the minute and second where you have the question. Explain your question briefly. Someone from our team will answer them. The spoken tutorial forum is for specific questions on this tutorial. Please do not post unrelated and general questions on them. This will help reduce the clutter. With less clutter, we can use this discussion as instructional material. Spoken Tutorial Project is funded by MHRD, Government of India. This is Meenal Ghoderao from IIT Bombay. Thank you for joining.